Hi, this is Marcy. Whether you're a food safety professional or simply interested in food safety for your home, AAA Food Handler Training School welcomes your questions. We invite you to visit www.aaafoodhandler.com, where you'll find our Frequently Asked Questions page, which lists answers to some of the most often asked questions. Or call us toll-free at 1-877-222-3487. Our classroom-style video courses for food safety managers provide over 5.5 hours of training to prepare you for your ANSI-approved and nationally accepted food manager certification exam. And now, here's a segment on pasteurization from one of our courses.
Campylobacter is a problem in dairy products. It is a bacteria that cows do carry. Dairy products must all be pasteurized to grade A or better requirement. Now, when we receive dairy products, typically milk, half and half, the creamers for the coffee, cheeses, they're all required to be grade A pasteurized. However, in addition to this grade A pasteurization, we also have ultra pasteurized, and then we have a UHT pasteurization. First of all, let's talk about what the pasteurization process is. The pasteurization process is a process whereby we treat the food with a high temperature for a very short time. And they do this over and over and over. And by doing this, they destroy the pathogenic bacteria that may be in there. However, it does not change the consistency of the food. Ice cream is pasteurized, believe it or not. So there are many products where we can do this. Now, milk, whether it's 0% fat, 2%, or just whole milk, those are what we call grade A pasteurized. And because it's only grade A pasteurized, in order to get rid of things like E. coli and Campylobacter and so forth, they have a shorter shelf life, generally about 2 weeks, as long as it's properly refrigerated. Then we have something called ultra-pasteurized. Ultra-pasteurized is where they take it to a higher temperature process for pasteurization. Because of that, it is safer for a longer period of time. An example of that would be half and half. If you get half and half milk product, creamer, you generally see that their expiration date is not 2 weeks, but closer to 30 days. And that's because it has undergone a ultra-pasteurized process. However, an ultra-pasteurized product still must be kept under proper refrigeration the whole time. They are not allowed to be left at room temperature. Then we have the highest pasteurization safety margin, which would be the UHT. UHT stands for ultra-high temperature. Ultra-high temperature products can be left at room temperature up to 90 days as long as you have not broken the seal. However, if you break the seal, they must go immediately to the refrigerator. Common UHT pasteurized products are those little creamers for coffees. Now, the creamers that for coffees that are UHT pasteurized, unfortunately, they make both ultra and ultra high temperature. So they're commonly mistaken for each other. The ultra cannot be left at room temperature. The UHT can be left at room temperature until it's opened. So if you serve those, please make sure you look at the box, the packaging, to see whether you're handling ultra or UHT pasteurized products. And if it's ultra, you have to keep it refrigerated. If it's UHT, you can leave it at room temperature as long as it's not open, up to 90 days. Oh, another thing regarding pasteurization, there's another word that is commonly confused, and that is the word homogenized. Milk products, when you receive them, often have homogenized, vitamin D, fortified, pasteurized grade A, which is required by law for food safety, homogenizing or pasteurizing? Homogenizing has nothing to do with safety. It is a quality issue. Please remember that. So in terms of food safety, homogenization is not a requirement. Pasteurization is a requirement. What homogenizing does is when milk comes out from the cow, there's a lot of fat particles, and they separate over time, especially under refrigeration. It doesn't look very appealing. especially when you pour it out. So in order to minimize that, they go through what's called the homogenizing process, which is blending it at a very high speed. So all the fat particles get incorporated into the milk, and when you pour it, it comes out nice and smooth, so it doesn't look so bad. That's what the homogenizing process is about. It has nothing to do with safety, it's all about quality. Okay? Pasteurization is what's important for safety.
AAA Food Handler Training School offers programs for basic food handlers, certified professional food safety managers, convenience store food safety managers, grocery store food safety managers, as well as certified food safety HACCP managers, which prepare you to take and pass ANSI-approved exams from the National Registry of Food Safety Professionals, ServSafe, and Prometric. By working with over 2,500 testing centers throughout the United States, we can easily schedule your exam at a date and time that is convenient to you. Also, please visit our website, www.aaafoodhandler.com, for interesting newsletters, articles, and products regarding the food service industry.